hosting a meeting in your WebEx Personal Room.
In this video, I'll demonstrate how to launch and host a meeting using my Personal Room from the Connecticut Community College's WebEx site, ctedu.webex.com. I go through the sign-in process in another video, so I've already logged in. By the way, here's one place where you can find your personal room URL. It appears right on this page, so you can easily share it in various ways. To start the meeting, I use this drop-down arrow. I have the desktop app installed on my computer, and it's set as the default. So when I start the meeting, it will use the desktop app. If you see a dialog box asking if you want to open Cisco WebEx Meetings, you can click the checkbox to always allow the app to start. In this case, I'm not going to select that because I want this dialog box to show for demonstration purposes. So I'm just going to click Open Cisco WebEx Meeting. Now I see a new window with my name and personal room up at the top. Before I click the Start Meeting button again, I have some options to choose first. If you click on Audio, you can use your computer's audio and built-in microphone. Sometimes this is called VoIP. You can also have WebEx call you at the phone number you enter. That way, there's never a toll charge. You can use your phone to call in to the number that will be made available after you join the meeting. Or you can choose not to connect to audio at all. However, this is not recommended. Don't try to run your WebEx meetings with chat only. Your attendees will have the exact same audio options. If you click on Test Speaker and Microphone, you can select which speaker you wish to use and test it. You can select which microphone you wish to use, your built-in webcam mic or your headset, for example, and you can test your microphone. I'm going to leave these settings as is and click the small X at the top right to close this dialog box. At the bottom of the window are buttons that enable you to mute or unmute your own mic. And if you click Start Video, you can choose which camera you want to display, if you have more than one. Most people just use their webcam. You do not have to share your video if you don't want to, and you can also turn it on and off during the meeting. Now I'm ready to click Start Meeting. And next, a new live meeting window will display. That's where your participants will join you. And here's my WebEx Personal Room window. Now, before I continue, I want to show you something that often confuses people. Sometimes people will go in and, let's say, close their web browser, like this. And they may even minimize their meeting window. Then they can't figure out how to get back to their meeting. They think sometimes that if they relaunch the web browser, they can get back into it. But in fact, all you need to do is look down at your taskbar and click on this little Cisco WebEx Meeting globe icon. When you click on that, as long as you hadn't closed the actual meeting, then it will just open up your meeting window once again. So you can minimize it, and then you can click on the globe icon to show the meeting window once again. This gray area here is the display area. This is where any shared content of your whiteboard will display. At the bottom, in addition to the mute button and the video buttons, you'll now also see a button to share content, a record button, and also a reactions button, which includes feedback options and the raise hand function. Clicking the three dots provides additional options, including enabling breakout sessions. At the top left is the menu, file, edit, share, etc. I'm not going to cover every option from this menu, but I recommend that you look them all over. A few highlights. Under the File menu, you can find and try out various options that you'll find here, but I wanted to point out that if you create a poll and save it for reuse, this is where you'll go to navigate to your saved poll questions file in order to load them for use in your current WebEx meeting. There are separate videos in our WebEx playlist about how to use WebEx polls. I'll skip over the Edit menu and show you the Share menu. This is one of the ways that you can get to your Share content options, which is the sharing option that is most often used. The other way is to click the little Share button at the bottom of your screen. One other interesting share option to take note of if you are helping someone to learn to use WebEx is Share My Meeting Window. This actually shows them your host view, and it's a great way to help somebody learn how to accomplish certain tasks as a host. On the View menu, you can set what panels display in the right side frame, and you can restore the default layout, hide panels, or add panels that are not showing. Audio and video gives you microphone and camera options. If you click Participant, you can control muting of all attendees. You can send invitations on the fly. You can control who can share and control attendee privileges. First of all, we recommend that you deselect anyone can share before your meeting begins. Now, the attendee privileges are particularly important for faculty, as there have been reported hacking incidents. If I open this up, you'll see there are two tabs, Communicate and Participants. You can take some precautions prior to your meetings by deselecting some of the meeting defaults. But remember, you have to do this every time you start a meeting. WebEx does not currently provide a way to permanently reset these defaults. On the Communicate tab, you may want to disable attendees' ability to communicate with everyone, at least initially. On the Participants tab, you may want to disable the ability for attendees to see the entire participant list. You have already disabled their ability to share documents, and you will also most likely want to deselect giving attendees the power to control shared applications, web browsers, and other people's computers remotely. Later on, you may wish to allow attendees to share documents. Once you're done changing your defaults, be sure to click OK. The meeting menu enables you to copy your meeting link, and you can also unlock or lock your meeting from here. You can also start recording by clicking the Start Recording option here or by clicking the Record button down at the bottom. Note that in the Recorder Settings submenu, we recommend that you leave the option Record in the Cloud instead of recording it locally on your computer, because in WebEx, we have an auto transcription functionality turned on. So as long as you have recorded your meetings in the cloud on the WebEx servers, WebEx will generate an automatic transcript using speech recognition, which is editable to correct any errors. Then, if you share those links to the meetings, those watching the recordings can see the transcript in a side panel. Remember that you can always download your recordings as MP4 video files to your computer later on for backup, but these will not include the transcript. Now, let's take a look over in the right side frame. Here, you'll typically see the participants list, and you'll see the chat panel. Notice that you can minimize or maximize them by clicking these little drop-down arrows. Now, if you locked your personal room by default in your personal room settings, or if you had locked it within the meeting, as I did here, under meeting, you can see that I have the unlock meeting, and I could also have locked it from here. Then, when your meeting is locked, when someone tries to enter your meeting, you'll be notified and you'll have to admit them. So let's take a look at what this looks like. I have a person who is about to join my meeting, which is locked. So here's the person who's going to join. I'm showing this in a separate browser window. Now I'm going to join the personal room meeting. As an attendee, I see a message that says you can join after the host admits you. Now let me click back as the host, and you can see that I have a little banner here that lets me know that somebody is waiting and I have a choice as to whether to admit Jane attendee. When I click admit, Jane appears in the participant list. Once someone joins, notice that the icon to the left of their name indicates how they joined audio. The headset tells me that they joined via computer audio. If they had joined by phone, I would see a little cell phone icon. If there's no icon next to their name, it means that the person has not joined audio in WebEx, although they may have called in, and in that case, they may show in the participant list as an unlisted caller.
If an attendee is unmuted, I can click their microphone to mute them. The microphone would be in green. However, if I want to unmute them, I have to request that they unmute. You can't just automatically unmute somebody because it's possible that they might have muted themselves because they're having a private conversation. So I'm going to click request unmute, and my attendee will get a request asking them to unmute themselves, but they can choose not to unmute themselves. If you want to send a personal chat message to a particular attendee, you can right-click and select chat, and then a message can be sent directly to that individual. You can always select who you want to send messages to from the drop-down menu. Now I could change this back to everyone, and I could send a chat message that all attendees would see. If you right-click on a person's name, you can change their role. You could make them the presenter or a host or a co-host. If you want to make somebody the presenter, select that role, and that will enable them to share content. However, be aware that if you make someone the host, you can no longer control the meeting. They would have to change your role back to host. To share your entire computer screen, everything that you have open on your computer, select the Share button and then select Screen 1 at the top. If you happen to have more than one monitor, you'll see, for example, Screen 1 and Screen 2. But you need to click the Screen icon in order to share everything on your computer screen. So if I click this Share button, then you can see that what I am sharing is everything that I have open. So I have Blackboard open, and all of my attendees would see Blackboard, and I also happen to have a Word document open. So they would see all of this. Now, what if I really didn't want them to see any other applications or documents that I had open? I only wanted them to see, for example, this Word document. So to share only a specific application, click the Share button. But this time, from the little icons down below, select only the application that you want your attendees to see. In this case, I want them to see the Microsoft Word application, so I'll click that. Now, the only thing that my attendees will see is this Word document. Everything else will not display at all. And if I happen to click, let's say, on my browser to bring Blackboard forward, what they would see now is just a gray box. I could be talking about what was in Blackboard, but they would not see it because I'm only sharing Microsoft Word. Now I want to show you just a couple of other important things about content sharing in WebEx. First of all, when I click the Share button, note up at the top left here that by default, the content sharing is optimized for text and images. However, if you wanted to share a YouTube video, for example, or a video that you had on your computer, you could select Optimize for Motion and Video so that the streaming media would display better. And be sure that the checkbox that says Share Your Computer Audio is selected. It may not be selected by default. Once you've done that, select the screen or the application that you wish to share. Now, note that when I begin sharing, there's a panel that displays, and I have a number of different options here. I can stop sharing or pause. I can share something different, mute, unmute, record, etc. So take a look at the options that are shown here. I also want to point out that when I mouse away from this panel, the panel disappears up at the top of my screen. Mouse back over this and the panel will redisplay. I hope this video has given you a good overview of how to host your own meetings in WebEx's Personal Room. If you have any questions, contact your college's local educational technology staff.